It's news time. Information is power. The current. The news headline. Renu Omokri. Why Buhari has refused to open Nigeria-Benin Republic border. Renu Omokri, a former aide to ex-president Goodluck Jonathan, has suggested why President Muhammadu Buhari has refused to reopen the Nigeria-Benin Republic border. Omokri claimed that Buhari was trying to pressure the Benin Republic government to hand over Yoruba Nation agitator Sunday Igboho to his administration. He said the claim by the Nigerian government that the border was closed to tackle smuggling of goods and weapons and to tackle the menace of banditry is a lie. In a tweet on Thursday, Omokri wrote, Buhari claims he closed the Benin Republic Nigeria border because of banditry. That is a lie from the mouth of Lai Mohammed. The real reason behind the closure is to pressure the Beninoise government to hand over Igboho to him. Beninoise security operatives currently locked up Igboho after he was arrested in Cotonou. The Yoruba Nation agitator was arrested at an airport in Cotonou while trying to travel to Germany, and the separatist had fled Nigeria to Cotonou after he was declared wanted by the Department of State Services, DSS. DSS had declared him wanted after weapons were found in his house in the Soka area of Ibadan, Oyo State. However, he had denied ownership of the weapons found in his house. Other news.
Rehabilitation and upgrading of Abuja Kefi Makurdi Road project and Nigerian Railway Modernization Project Lagos-Ibadan section. The projects also have the added benefits of job creation, not only by themselves, but through direct and indirect service providers, a number of which are small and medium enterprises, the document said. Although these loans are project tied, many Nigerians are concerned with the current debts and rejected President Muhammadu Buhari proposal for a new loan. Minister of Finance, Budget and National Planning, Zainab Ahmed, assured the nation that the country's debt is still manageable. Nigeria's debt is still very much within sustainable limits. We need to roll out infrastructure now and grow the economy now, not later, she said.
Report stated that the federal government borrowings, both local and foreign debt, had climbed from 3.55 trillion naira in 1999 to 26.91 trillion at the end of March 2021, saying that that is the current country's official figure. And since 1999, when Nigeria returned to democracy, Nigeria has had four presidents: Olusegun Obasanjo, Umaru Yar'Adua, Goodluck Ebele Jonathan, and Muhammadu Buhari. This report looks at the loans taken under the four administrations of these presidents. Number one, the ex-president Obasanjo, the external debt, there was a reduction from $28.04 billion in 1999 to $2.11 billion in 2007, and that is for external debt. And for domestic debt, there was increase from 798 billion naira to 2.17 trillion naira. Now back to the federal government debt, there was reduction from 3.55 trillion naira in 1999 to 2.42 trillion naira in 2007. The federal government's local and foreign debt level, there was 31.8% reduction, and the exchange rate as at then was 98.02 naira for 106.8 naira to $1. Therefore, there is need to note that there was huge decline in foreign debt, and that was a result of the substantial reduction following the payoff of the outstanding debts owed to the London clubs of creditors in the first quarter of 2007. And now to Yar'Adua / Jonathan regime 2007 to 2011. The foreign debt, there was increase for $2.11 billion in 2007 to $3.5 billion in 2011. Talking about the domestic debt, there was increase from 2.17 trillion naira in 2007 to 5.62 trillion naira in 2011. The exchange rate also increased from 106.8 naira to $1 and also from 156.7 naira to $1. And the percentage increase, unlike the last year, the previous regime was 155%. Therefore, there is need to note that the debt figure Jonathan completed the tenure from May 2010 to May 2011 after the death of Yar'Adua. During the period, the debt reportedly rose from 4.9 trillion naira to 6.17 trillion naira, which means there was an increase of about 24.9% in 1 year. Basically, the ex-president Jonathan regime, where it started fully after the death of Yar'Adua and he was re-elected, it started fully 2011. The external debt was $3.5 billion, and the domestic debt was 5.62 trillion naira. Accumulated debt was actually 6.17 trillion naira. And in 2014, there was another foreign debt, $6.45 billion, and a domestic debt of 7.9 trillion naira. And the exchange rate also stood at 197 naira per dollar. And the total public debt from 2011 to 2015 increased from 6.17 trillion naira in 2011 to a whooping amount of 9.8 trillion naira in 2015, meaning there was an increase of 3.63 trillion naira. And the percentage increase this time around was 58.8%. And yet, to this current regime, President Muhammadu Buhari from 2015, external debt was actually $7.35 billion, and the domestic debt was 8.84 trillion naira, and the foreign rate was actually 197 naira for a dollar. And in 2020, external debt was also $28.57 billion, domestic debt was 16.02 trillion naira, and the domestic debt increased from 7.63 trillion naira, that is in June 2015, to December 2020, and the external borrowing also increased from increased by 21.27 billion as at December 2020. And the foreign exchange now is actually 381 naira per dollar as at 2020, meaning there was a percentage increase of 173.2% from 2015. And the analysis is that all this regime as at then, there were accumulations of debt, and President Muhammadu Buhari is actually the country's biggest borrower, increasing the public debt of the federal government by more than 173%, because the Yar'Adua Jonathan administration took the second plot, that's the second one, at about 155% surge in borrowing. And the third spot is occupied by Jonathan regime, which recorded 58.8% increase. And the last four administrations, only Obasanjo administration reduced the public debt. However, the principal lawmaker, that is the Senate President Lawan, has says that the President Muhammadu Buhari needs to reduce the external borrowing incurred to fund the country's annual budget, saying that he's advising that they should focus on blocking financial leakages and avoid wastage in all tiers of government. Thanks for listening.